Hey guys, welcome to the video. So today we are going to be discussing how to film a festival vlog. Now this is a video I've wanted to do on my channel for quite a while now, but obviously because we were without festivals for a really long time, I'm a little bit out of practice. I haven't filmed a vlog since 2019, which is crazy, but this is something that is a big part of my channel. And as we are going into hopefully a very busy fall festival season, I will be vlogging a lot. So you guys can expect those videos to come on my channel. But I do get questions pretty often about how to film at festivals. So what equipment do you use? Do you use a phone? Do you use a camera? What makes a successful vlog? What types of shots should you be getting? All of that good stuff. So I am going to be addressing all of that in today's video. I'm definitely going to share some tips and advice from my own experiences and just walk you guys through how you can go about filming any festivals you plan on attending. Also, quickly, I wanted to mention this upcoming Monday, August 9th at 8 p.m. Eastern, my good friend Vibe with Aid and I are going to be hosting our first joint masterclass called How to Become a Festival Content Creator. So if any of you guys have thought about starting your own YouTube channels or a podcast or an Instagram or TikTok page dedicated to the EDM community or music festivals, then this might be the perfect class for you. We are going to walk you guys through everything you need to know about starting a page, how to brainstorm content, how to put together a content strategy, and then we're going to talk about filming and how to balance that and just tips and advice, equipment you're going to need. And we're also going to address some, you know, self-limiting beliefs or roadblocks that might come up for you that kind of hold you back from actually starting and doing the damn thing. So if you guys are interested, I will put a link down below in the description box. Again, it is a masterclass happening this upcoming Monday, August 9th at 8 p.m. Eastern. We're so excited to work with creators inside of this. It's going to be a 90-minute session with a live Q&A at the end. So I hope to see some of you guys inside of there. With all that being said, let's jump right into the tips. Okay, so first and foremost, let's talk equipment because I know this is a big one and I know this kind of can like hold people back from starting. I highly recommend you can just film on your phone. For most festivals, I'm filming on my iPhone. When I started, over 4 years ago, I had an iPhone 6, I want to say. Quality not great. By the time I started my YouTube channel, I don't even know what iPhone I had, but most cameras on your iPhones or on your whatever phone you have will be fine and the quality will be great to get started with. You do not need to go buy a super fancy camera with a microphone and lighting and all of that if you are just getting started with a new page. Like, you can definitely work your way up to that and invest in yourself later. And it also depends on the event. So for example, for EDC Las Vegas, I've always filmed that on my phone. Depending on the type of camera you have, I'm going to recommend a point and shoot, which is what I'm currently filming on. I'll show you guys a picture here, but a point and shoot is a smaller camera. It usually weighs less and it does not have a detachable lens. So most festivals will allow you to bring something like that in. Usually you cannot bring like a really nice professional quality camera that has a separate lens or lighting or microphone. It depends on the event, but most of them qualify that as like a professional camera. And if you're not a part of media or press, you can't bring that in. But I have brought my point and shoot to things like Ever After. I brought it to Imagine Music Festival. I've brought it to Electric Zoo. Some of those were more local or some of those I had media passes for. So I chose to bring my nicer camera. But at some big events when I don't want to carry both my camera and my phone in my hydration bag, then I will just opt to shoot on my phone. So it's whatever is most convenient for you, but you can totally get away with just using the camera on your phone. But I do have some recommended cameras real quick and I will put links down below. So I have a Canon G7X Mark II. I believe there is a Mark III version made now. The Sony ZV-1 I've heard incredible things about and that seems to be very highly recommended for best vlogging cameras in 2021. The Sony A6000, I know my friend Vibe with Aid has that one, but that does have a detachable lens that you can put on it. The Sony A6400, the Canon EOS M6 Mark II was recommended. And then you have smaller cameras you can bring too. A GoPro, totally acceptable. The festival finesser uses a GoPro, and they had a DJI Pocket 2, which I'll pop a picture. These are really small and they fit in your pocket and they can still film really high quality footage. So there's tons of options out there if you do find yourself wanting to invest in a camera down the line, but those are all great options for you. So the next thing I want to talk about is actually structuring your vlog, because this is a big one. I don't know if you guys do this, but anytime I'm about to attend a festival, I watch vlogs and after movies. For me as a user, I just want to see what the experience is like. Plus, I want to get hype, right? It's either I really want to build excitement and I'm really pumped to go to this festival, or I want to see what it's all about. Like, what is the security like? What do the stages look like? What is the layout of the festival? So if you're going to be filming a vlog, you might want to think about these things beforehand, because you want your vlog to either suit one of these needs of a person watching it, right? You either really want to build hype for people, or you really want to help them, or you want to do both together, which is totally doable as well. So before you head to an event, think about your shots in advance, right? You can totally go the route of just getting to a festival and filming whatever and throwing that up as a video, but that may not do as well, and you may not see a growth in that. So definitely highly recommend filming an intro and an outro to your vlog. So hop on camera and film an intro. Introduce yourself. Say who you are, where you're going, what the game plan is. You definitely want to set up the flow of your video so that it's not just like, oh, it starts and we're in the middle of a set at main stage with absolutely no context, no introduction. People don't get to know you as a person, right? So definitely think about your shots in advance. The other huge part of this is storytelling. Tell a story with your vlog. Actually show the progression of the day, make it as helpful as possible. Again, you could document everything from like the road trip you're taking to the getting ready process and the pregame, like introduce your friends to the vlog. All of that kind of helps make your vlog more unique and it allows the person watching to connect to you more as a creator. So include all of that. Show every aspect of it. If you're going to go get food, show what the food is like, you know, show the different prices, then capture all of the different sets that you're going to. If there's any really cool moments that happen or like any magical festival moments, definitely document those as well. And you do not have to be filming the whole time too, right? Like you can definitely strike a balance between having fun and then filming certain moments. A festival might be 3 days long or it might be a couple hours long and you may only pull up your camera for an hour of the whole event, you know? So you definitely can still enjoy yourself and document a festival. I do it all the time. So it's a really fun way just to capture what the real experience is like and get that across in the vlog that you guys are creating. I would also recommend, like I said, shooting an outro. So definitely say goodbye to the vlog at the end. You could do a quick little recap the next day or some sort of outro where you're wrapping up the whole vlog. And then you can always do a CTA, which is a call to action. So you can let people, you know, say subscribe for more videos like this or follow me on Instagram, something like that at the end where you tell the audience where to go. Maybe it's, hey, stick around for part two of this vlog. Definitely end your video with something like that. Okay, the other thing I will highly recommend, be really careful with what your footage looks like. So again, it doesn't matter if you're shooting on a phone, but be really wary of putting a lot of like shaky or very hard to see footage in your vlog, because there's nothing more annoying than watching a vlog or after movie and it's just like somebody jumping up and down and the footage is going crazy, or it's muffled and you can't hear it that well. You definitely want to keep a pace with your vlog, right? People's attention spans are really short. So you want to keep things fast paced. You want to keep them moving. You don't want to just sit on main stage for 6 sets in a row and that's your entire vlog. Like that's not as interesting for somebody to watch. So definitely mix up your shots, have a variety of like different things, like I said, and just really make sure the quality of the video is good before you decide to put that clip in the vlog. Also, this is a big one because I see this all the time when I watch people's videos from festivals. Try not to skip like a large chunk of time. A lot of the times I will click on a vlog and it'll be like the introduction and then the pregame and then it's nighttime. And it's like 8 p.m. and they're at main stage in the middle of a crowd. And it's like, where did the whole day go? There's a whole chunk of time that's missing from this vlog. So try to be careful of that. I know it's easy to like forget because you get caught up in the moment, but if you are really trying to take this seriously and you do really want to capture everything, I put reminders in my phone sometimes that like pop up and it says like vlog. So definitely try not to skip like huge, large chunks of time. Again, the whole point is you really want to capture what the whole experience and context of the festival is like. And then the last things I will say here, as far as editing goes, definitely be careful of copyright issues. So this won't be an issue really too much in the beginning as your channel is growing, but when you go to monetize it in the future, say if you want to turn on Google AdSense, if you are using large clips from a set and it recognizes specific songs, your video can get copyrighted, which means it won't earn any ad revenue, or in some cases it can be completely blocked, which has happened to me plenty of times. It's really hard to toe that line when you are doing festival vlogs. So with me, what I'll do is I'll chop sets up like into really short segments, or I'll kind of like let a song play for 5 seconds, cut it, then skip to another part of the song. So it is a little jumpy, but it prevents it from recognizing that it's, you know, a song that could be copyrighted. So again, I personally, my style is to show more of the experience than prolonged sets, but some people do, their whole channels are uploading full sets. Just be wary that you can get copyrighted. And if you have 3 official strikes, your whole channel can get removed. So you do really want to be careful with that. A lot of the times if people do after movies, they won't have like any talking or any sound from the actual festival. They'll go pick copyright free music, which you can find in the YouTube library, or websites like Epidemic Sound. If you pay for that, you can download some really good music, and you can just put tracks underneath it that are copyright free, which definitely could work as well. So you guys, those are all of my tips. I'm definitely going to be going into this a little bit more in depth in the masterclass that I'm doing with Aid next Monday. So again, if you guys are interested in how to become a festival content creator, I highly encourage you guys sign up and check this out. We're going to be going over all of this and so much more to help you finally get started on a YouTube channel or a different page you want to start. But if sharing your passions for music festivals is something you're interested in, I will definitely leave a link down below so you guys can enroll. And again, that's happening Monday, August 9th at 8 p.m. Eastern. Thank you guys so much for watching. Definitely give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. And if you're new here, I would love it if you would consider subscribing. You can hit the button down below and turn on the post notifications bell so you never miss an upload. I'm also online at Emma Kapotes on Instagram, Twitter, and TikTok. And with all that being said, I hope you guys have an incredible week, and I will see you in my next video. Bye, guys. Fall into your-